Hello, viewer.
It's me, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and once again, I'm grateful to welcome you to Elimu TV, your station, where you watch and learn and have an experience. I'm taking you through chemistry form 4 today, and we are going to look at rates of reaction. Specifically, we look at chaterlier's principle. Previously, we have introduced ourselves to the factors that affect rates of reaction and reversible reactions. So let's pay attention and see how we can apply chaterlier's principle in solving some given problems and how it is applied in our day-to-day life activities. So what are the goals of this lesson? By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to, number one, you'll be able to state chaterlier's principle. You'll be able to show how a change in condition affects reversible reactions in terms of chaterlier's principle. And also, you'll lastly apply chaterlier's principle in problem solving. So why is this important for us to understand chaterlier's principle? So you'll find that most of the manufacturing industries and the processes that take place involve chemical reactions. And for us to come up with the best yield in an economical way, it is important for us to make sure that we vary conditions appropriately, because these chemical reactions occur at given chemical equilibriums. So as you can see from the diagram we have here, we have pressure gauge, we have cylindrical containers which are metallic. They can vary the temperature, they can vary the concentration. So it is important for a manufacturer who to be able to provide things or products in an economical way. A manufacturer is always interested in obtaining the highest yield at a minimum cost within the shortest time possible, hence making the process economical. So most of these reactions are reversible. So it's important we remind ourselves of what a reversible reaction is. We may consider the following: zinc oxide, which is white in color. By applying heat, that is raising the temperature, the product gives us zinc oxide, which is yellow in color. This is an example of a physical change because there is no change in the chemical composition of the compound. The other thing is when you on cooling of the same product, it goes back to zinc oxide, which is white in color. We also have other examples. We may look at manufacture of ammonia, which involves reaction between hydrogen and nitrogen. They are combined in the ratio of 1:3 to give us ammonia gas, and the process is exothermic. The H there, which is the symbol for enthalpy, is negative 92 kilojoules per mole. That tells us that the forward reaction is exothermic. Now, for a reaction which in which there is a chemical change of the product, some of these products are reversible, and that means ammonium gas can as well as decompose to give us can undergo thermal dissociation to give us nitrogen and hydrogen back. So a reaction in which both products or reactants form products and products form reactants is a perfect example of a reversible reaction. So we have the forward reaction and the backward reaction. So if the rate of the forward reaction can be at a point is equivalent to the rate of backward reaction, then we substitute the arrows up there to the arrows that we have in the second diagram. As you can see, they are different. So this sign shows that the reaction can reach an equilibrium, dynamic equilibrium. So chaterlier's principle. According to chaterlier, when a change in condition is applied to a system at equilibrium, the system moves in such a way to oppose that change. What are some of the conditions that may be changed in a chemical reaction? Concentration of either reactants or products. That is by removing the products once they are formed. That decreases the concentration of products. The second thing is increase or decrease in temperature. The increase of the temperature can affect, since it increases the kinetic energy of the reacting particles, therefore making the particles move faster, increasing the number of coalitions per unit time, hence increasing the rate of the reaction. Pressure, which only involves reactions that involves gases. We understand that pressure in solid and liquid cannot be affected since they cannot be compressed. And therefore, pressure only involves gases. So reactions involving gases, a change in pressure will affect the chemical equilibrium. And lastly, we may speed up or slow down the rate of the reaction by adding a catalyst. So when we add a catalyst, this will affect the equilibrium. And with reference to the chaterlier's principle, this will affect by opposing that change. The system opposes that change. So let's have a look at one of the application of the chaterlier's principle. So you can see we have a harbor process. This is an industrial plant we are going to consider. So in this plant, we have the raw materials to manufacture ammonia through the harbor process. And the raw materials are taken through various stages. One, we have purification, which removes impurities in the gases. And then we have to ensure that other conditions are kept optimum to ensure that the yield of ammonia is economical. Therefore, ammonia and nitrogen nitrogen and hydrogen react to give us ammonia. And the reaction, as we said, is exothermic. So those are things that we need first to identify here. And the reaction, the molar gas volume between the reactants and products is in the ratio of 4:2. This industrial plant can be represented in a system or in a flowchart diagram or a scheme where nitrogen is isolated from the air, hydrogen from natural gas, and the two are combined in the ratio of 1:3, and as you can see, we have the optimum conditions given there, and we need to interpret this scheme properly and provide the necessary conditions for us to obtain ammonia at a cost-effective way. So which are these conditions? Look at the following. Increase of temperature. Remember that the forward reaction is exothermic. Since the forward reaction is exothermic, increase in temperature favors or shifts the equilibrium to the right, hence decreasing the yield of ammonia. So this implies that yield of ammonia is less at high temperature. So by lowering the temperature, we will favor production of ammonia, which slows down the rate of ammonia. So we have to come up with an optimum condition. An increase in pressure in a closed system, the system favors the direction with fewer molecules, and this will favor, when we lower the pressure, the system will favor the direction with fewer molecules, therefore increasing the yield of ammonia. Affecting concentration, this is by removing the product once it is formed. The system will tend to oppose that change, and hence more nitrogen and hydrogen will react to produce ammonia. Optimum condition, therefore, for this production of in harbor process are a temperature of 450 degrees Celsius, high pressure of about 200 atmospheres, and a catalyst. Iron is preferred over platinum, which is expensive and easily poisoned by impurities. So can we see whether we have understood the concept? Let's answer the following question. Given the equation, sulfur 4 oxide plus oxygen, which gives us sulfur 4 oxide, explain what happens to the position of equilibrium when more sulfur 4 oxide is introduced to the system. The pressure of the system is reduced and the temperature is raised. We can apply the same concept with reference to Haber process as we have explained. You can as well as refer this information to the book that we have provided, Student Chemistry Book 3 and Book 4. And as well as Patel, but you can as well as view the following lessons, or you can reach us through an SMS, or you can visit us through our Facebook and YouTube account at Erimu TV, or Twitters at Erimu TV _KE. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi. Please pay attention to the lesson that follows. Thank you.